What is up, everybody? The Destroyer here, and welcome back to another cast of The Lord of the Rings, The Battle for Middle-earth 2, patch 1.08. Today we have a 3v3 on Daggerlad. So, we'll take a look at this game. Hopefully it's pretty good. Alright, let's see who we have in this game. We'll start on the left side here. We have Mr. QQQQ as the dwarves in the top left. On the first team, and his partner, DU Random. Let's call him Random. As a Mordor there in the middle, and their last partner is Memory as elves in the top right. The opposing team, we have Menji as the Men of the West in the bottom right. Bottom center, we have Radagast as goblins in the center there. And we have, last but no means least, Luminosity is the Men of the West in the bottom left. So we have Men of the West, two Men of the West and a goblin versus a dwarf, a Mordor, and an elf. So this should be interesting. There's no mirrors anywhere here, so that's kind of good. I always find diversity between factions facing off against each other more exciting than watching a mirror. But mirrors aren't bad. It's just, that's my personal opinion, I guess. I'm sure a lot of you share that opinion as well. Alright, looks like we have an elven barracks being constructed from Memory. He sent out some Lorien archers there. That'll be his first unit of choice. Random has not gone for anything as of yet. He's gone for three slaughterhouses and he's sitting on his income. Possibly saving for a hero? A quick Nazgul, maybe? I couldn't say. And Mr. QQ. I'll just call him Mr. QQ. Because that's amusing to me. That's probably what's supposed to mean anyway. He's going for a Hall of Warriors. Two Hall of Warriors? Going two Hall of Warriors. Getting a battalion of Guardians out. We do have a battalion of Soldiers of Gondor out for Luminosity. He's going for the barracks. Getting some more Gondor soldiers. Getting some farms set up here. Radagast has got himself a Fissure upgrading to level 2, so going for Half-Troll Marauders, I'm assuming, and Goblin Warrior spam. Goblin Warriors are 75 in this patch, and they 40 command points. But they're still quite useful. And of course we have Menji going for a Stables, getting some Gondor Knights out here. So we'll see how each player's thing fares off. It looks like Random was actually saving up for a Nazgul. As you see there, he's sending it in immediately. It looks like the elf player, Memory, has captured the outpost for the northern team, so that'll be useful for them. And Nazgul will be absolutely amazing for countering these Gondor Knights. As you see, though, he won't be killing them one hit, especially with the buff. They should probably have plenty of time to take on the outpost, it looks like. Nazgul will begin working him down, and once Nazgul actually gets level 2, which will be very shortly, he will actually get the Dread Visage, which will make things much easier for him, even with that buff. So he's opting to capture it instead. Probably the smarter idea of the two things. He has plenty of time to capture it, or he does not have plenty of time to destroy it, I guess. Doesn't look like anyone else has got over on the other side of the map as of yet. The elf player Memory pushing down, though. He has got a fair amount of guys. Look how vibrant the color is. Oh, it's just, that's the thing I like personally about 1.08, is the colors are very easy to see on the minimap and in-game. It also, in turn, makes your chat easier to read. Some of the players, or the colors, 2.02 could be a bit difficult to read. We have so a big dwarf army from Mr. QQ pushing down into the base of Luminosity. Does not really have the force necessary to stop this attack. He has some Gondor soldiers up here, which are actually doing some damage. So he's got some Gondor soldiers here as well, trying to cut off the reinforcements. Throwing up an arrow tower to try and help defense. Looks like the Eye of Sauron being put down upon the dwarves to help buff them. Undoubtedly from Random over here. Where's his Nazgul at, I wonder? He has got Courses of Umbar, Random does, and Easterlings out. So he's going for a tavern in a Rajan Palace there. And now we have an Arwen out for the elf player, Memory. And he's also got a battalion of Lorien Archers, Swordsmen, and two battalions of Mithril Sentries. So that's going to be a threat. It's a goblin player, Radagast, going to help out his ally, Menji, here. Looks like they might get the stables down, though. but they will be losing a lot of guys in the process. Oh, we also have some Lorien, Elven Warriors. That is a in-unit for the Men of the West of patch 1.08, as you see there. I do actually like this unit quite a bit. I do wish it was in 2.02 of some description. They are very... The model, let alone... I don't care about the guy itself, but the model just looks phenomenal, I think. Whether they fit or not is another story. Luminosity seems to be having a bit of issue here, fending his base off. But it looks like he will actually manage to save his base from the dwarves. They are falling fairly rapidly here. And he has cut off the forward mines. No, he is actually still working on cutting out the forward mines. He should be able to take that down, though. Let's see what's going on in the middle here. We got a lot of goblins against some Mordor. There's a Nazgul in there. No, that's Cave Bats. Never mind. Cave Bats are weakening the army of Random. He does have his Nazgul over here. Still level 4 there. Very nice. Alright, looks like Minji walking around with some cavalry still. He does have a few battalions of Elven Warriors as well as some Gondor's archers there. Trying to burst down Arwen. Doesn't seem to be working out too well. Once she does get level 4, she does get the Flood, which is incredibly strong. So Arwen can be quite useful. We have a Haldir out in the field for, I'm assuming, would be Memory, since he's the only Elven player in the game. Haldir has his uses, especially once he gets to leadership. Very useful indeed once he gets to that point. And it looks like he managed to pick up one of the farms there. It gets canceled. And now Legolas has been brought out for Memory as well. Memory now sitting on 3 Elven Heroes. It'll be very difficult to deal with, especially with the support of this Nazgul. You see, it's very little slow when he tramples through guys. And there's a big Flood there from Arwen. The recharge time on Flood is fairly lengthy. It has been discussed. It's actually a tactic I used to use, was once you use Flood, you just get Arwen killed. And then you get another Flood as soon as you revive her. It's not very feasible in 2.02 because of Rise of the Witch King, because of the increased respawn timer of heroes. But in Battlefield 2, I don't think patch 1.08 does have a increased respawn timer. And I definitely know 1.06 and 1.00 do not. So it is a feasible option in the base game. Looks like we do have a Gloin here for Mr. QQ. He will have to flee, though, as his guys are being overwhelmed. There are an Aragorn at level 4 and a Boromir level 4 here. Quite powerful. For Luminosity. We have a bit of a skirmish still in the center here. Goblin's still trying to fend off Mordor and elves. It's going to be a bit difficult, to say the least. He's definitely going to need the help of his Men of the West partner here. Even the other one, if he can manage. If he can fend off the dwarves long enough. Which seems to be happening. Dwarves have no forward mines anywhere near his base. It doesn't seem they are anywhere close to it. Although, Mr. QQ going for battle wagons. That could be very, very useful indeed. We have a barricade being thrown out by Random there. And a Gorkil the Goblin King being brought out from Radagast, throwing down his totem there, which I believe gives a buff. Reveals nearby shroud, detects stealth, and provides 50% bonus armor to nearby allies. Very useful. And with a Nazgul death scream there, Random does lose his Nazgul. You always know in patch 1.08 when you lose a Nazgul. It's very noticeable. And you definitely notice when Aragorn dies in patch 1.08 as well. Kind of hoping no Aragorns die, because I don't like the Aragorn death song of patch 1.08. It's too long, and it's loud, and it's annoying. But other than that, fine. We have Haldir barely getting out of there. Tom Bombadil being summoned in by Minji there. Trying to take out these Easterlings. Ooh, Random has the Witch King. That's not good. Witch King is very powerful. In flight and on ground, of course. And we have a big attack from the Men of the West player Luminosity against the dwarf player Mr. QQ. Random sending the Witch King to help. Which is definitely a good choice. Because the dwarven player is in a lot of trouble here. He doesn't have any defenses except for Gloin. But Gloin will fall to Aragorn. Aragorn does have Blade Master going. You see that, he has like a glowing white effect instead of a red one like all the other patches, which I do actually like, prefer. I think it fits more with the theme of good players. And of course this is a thing as well. The knockdown effect. There it is. There's the Blade Master effect. I do like that effect. Quite nice. Yeah, the knockdown effect for when a flying unit hits a hero makes it impossible to get away. I don't like that feature. I'm glad that was removed from 2.02 because it is something I couldn't stand from patch 1.06 when I was playing it. Once somebody got a flying unit, you pretty much lost your hero at that point. It's really annoying. Aragorn got getting a triple strike there. Iron Nazgul. Morgul Blade, that's the word I'm looking for. Aragorn using Elendil, trying not to die. He is being surrounded by Mordor troops there. Random looking to finish him off. An eagle being brought out by Memory. Good choice against the goblins. Goblins don't seem to have any anti-air, so they will be getting picked off left and right. The eagle, of course, is white here. Very cool. White with blue wings, it looks neat. I don't know how feasible that would be for a real bird, but it looks cool nonetheless. Aragorn, no chance of him getting away. He'd be impossible to get away from the Corsairs of Umbar by themselves. And there it is, the Aragorn Death Song. I really dislike that, to be honest. Oh, look how long it lasts! Yeah, well, when he's done with his solo, there we go. We have Minji with a fairly sizable force of Men of the West. He has some Ithilien Rangers now. It just says Rangers. Interesting. It doesn't actually say Ithilien Rangers when you mouse over them. Like it should. We get some Tower Guards as well. Legolas and Tom Bombadil chasing them off though. Minji's Boromir is level 4, almost level 5. When she gets to level 5, he'll get the 50% damage bonus from Boromir's leadership. We have trees sprouting up around the Men of the West fortress there. Oh, Luminosity's been defeated. This fortress has been taken out. I totally missed that. Apologies. But I'm sure you get the gist of it. Corvo getting knocked off his scorpion there. Yeah, big attack from Random. Managing to take out Mordor. Or not Mordor, the Men of the West. Very good attack indeed. Not even the goblins or the Men of the West were able to stop him. Dwarves might have been in here somewhere as well. You see there is a battle wagon and Gloin here. Gloin, of course, would help taking down a fortress fairly easily. Alright, well, looks like he's been successful over there. Let's take a look how things are going over here. It is now 2-on-3. Things will be increasingly more difficult for the bottom team, as you would expect. Eagle taking a bit of damage, but should be fine. And now more Mordor troops pushing in from the north with the Elven team. Goblins getting 3 battalions of Goblin archers to try and counter this eagle, I'm assuming. As the eagle will be a real pain in his ass for most of the game. And has been. Witch King is level 5 now. At level 6 he gets Screech, I guess is useful. Looks like Radagast has taken control of any Men of the West buildings that Luminosity did still have. So he is benefiting from a few farms, and he has the stables as well. Radagast, of course, is the goblin player. He won't be probably using too many of those. Beacon being thrown in there by Random. Well, Gloin is going to get killed here. This half troll is going to finish him off, it looks like, and he will go down. big hit from the Witch King, though, killing off a lot of units there. Witch King is very powerful. If you can't keep him under control, he will wreck your army very, very easily. Even the Summonman of Dale getting destroyed here. And we do have Forge Blades upgrades on all the Mordor troops. We'll, of course, be doing fairly good damage. Darkness being cast down. Rogoth being brought out. Particularly power points while we have time. Dwarves. Have the Men of Dale. Rally call. 8 power points.
We'll call for some guardians.
Tom Bombadil. Farsight. Heal. Which is 15 power points for the elf player.
My time grows short.
So there's a battle up here. There. Darkness being brought out by random there. It's like Witch King fighting the Fire Drake. Looks like he will be successful. He's got Barricade and Eye of Sauron. 14 power points. And we have a Watcher for the Goblin player, Radagast, and Wildman, and King Bats. Sounds like we have a Summon Eagles from the Elves there. Menji, the Men of the West, over here. He just had Eagles summoned on his fort and is being burst down by Mirkwood's Silverthorns. Does have Tom Bombadil. Looks like he's using Tom Bombadil. A big Sonic Song here could be huge. Oh, that kills a lot of guys. It leaves a lot of them alive as well, but it did kill the majority of them. He might be able to save his base here. In fact, I think he will be able to. He's got Elven Wood and Heal as well. 4 power points remaining. That's what everyone's got so far. Looks like the Eagle attack was fended off, fortunately, for the Men of the West player. How did he burst down there? These are a lot of archers. These can also turn to sword mode as well. That's the nice thing about the Elven Warriors. They are very versatile in what they can do. So just a generally cool unit. But they don't get silver thorns like regular elves. Well, there's an arrow volley. Will that manage to hit? It does indeed. Oh no, actually. That was thrown down by Menji. Stop Random from attacking him. Drogoth's getting some good damage in. He doesn't need to be careful with his barricade, though. He will die to it if he stays there too long. And now Radagast trying to shore up his defenses a bit. He does have a dwarf and a Mordor army right outside his base. So as you would expect, things are not looking good for him. And the dwarves continuing to build troops. Send them about. Random's base looking fairly safe. He's got a few of these taverns to decrease the cost of the Corsairs of Umbar, of course, and probably just to get more out in general at one time. And the Elven player Memory has, of course, a level 2 archer. That's not archer range. Elven barracks to get his guys there. So far, the bottom team is holding, though. I think it is only a matter of time before they are overwhelmed, unless they can manage to take out one of the northern teams. It will always be 3-on-2, which will be increasingly difficult. The more power points Mordor gets, the worse off they will be. I mean, that's generally speaking for every team, but if Mordor summons a Balrog, that could really, really be bad for either the Goblin player or the Men of the West player. As Balrog tends to destroy an entire base with the exception of the fortress. Balrog's just very strong. We do have a Mouth of Sauron out as well, level 4, so he does have Doubt and Evil Eye, which is nice. Which King needs to be a little bit careful there. There are a lot of arrow towers. Arrows of Fire Arrows upgrades are the way to bring in the Witch King best, I believe. As with all Nazgul, unless they're on horseback and he runs into pikes, that is a good way to get an Nazgul killed, but they are weak to fire. Which is also shown in the movies when Aragorn lights them on fire and they run away. Weathertop or whatever.
Watch out!
We do have some Rivendell Lancers here with some armor upgrades. They're trying to kill down these Rohirrim. Mirkwood's doing a good job of bursting them down. Trying their best. They're not the greatest unit against them, but they do fairly well. Looks like the Rohirrim will retreat back to heal up. They do have the banners. Well, that one doesn't. But this one is level 2, so they will start healing up. He could get a healing well. I think he has a house of healing, though, so looks like he will heal up there. Around his fortress. Assuming the house of healing works the same as every other patch of Battle of Middle-earth 2. I have no idea. Got a battle wagon here with the hearth on it. That's something I personally like to put on my battle wagons a lot, because it'll heal itself. It's kind of nice. And of course you can move it around and heal your troops. Looks like Drogoth does not approve of it though, and he is going to chase it down and try and kill it. And does actually one-shot it. So flying units apparently very good for killing battle wagons. Who would have guessed? Probably everybody. The Watcher being summoned down by Radagast, killing off and making the rest of Random's army flee north. So Mordor will have to regroup. He has brought out some Haradrim archers now. Not a bad choice. Haradrim archers are very good. The late game archer unit for Mordor, of course. Much better than the orc archer counterpart. I'm trying to get rid of these forward mines, keep the dwarves out of their lands. Which is fair, because you don't want a dwarf in your lands. Generally speaking, I wouldn't want a dwarf army in my territory. They managed to get it right before it finishes. Right out there. Darkness being cast down. Was this by goblins or Mordor? Random uses darkness. It looks like another West player. No? Benji used his club breaking. Everybody's using shit, I have no idea. But we have a nice flyer flight there. Big hit on the Dwarven army. Kills off a majority of it, actually. If the Southern team actually won this game, I would be super surprised. But it looks like that's not going to happen. The fortress is gone now for Menji. So it is only a matter of time before the Men of the West player falls here, leaving Radagast, the Goblin player, by himself. Putting up a defense though. He's not dead yet. Eagle Summon is almost off cooldown though, so Memory will be able to summon that soon to help out. We have Untamed Allegiance, which heals friendly allies in patch 1.08. Interesting. I always like to see the changes between different patches. That is definitely a different one. We have a lot of power points here for Radagast, the Goblin player, who hasn't got his 25 for some reason. There he goes. He's got a Balrog. I'm going to hold off on his camera, or hold on his camera until I see he summons it, then I can look for it, because I might miss it. I hate missing Balrogs. I'm sure he'll use it at some point, either in defense or offense. Possibly he will push north with this army to try and use his Balrog. I guess we'll see. Lots of Haradrim archers being brought down from the north, though. From Random with some Corsairs of Umbar and the Mouth of Sauron leading the charge. Wow, that is a lot of actual Haradrim archers. Does he have the fire arrow upgrade? Well, they don't actually get fire arrows in patch 1.08. Interesting. Possibly they wouldn't have in patch 1.06 as well, I don't remember. Well, I don't know if he's going to use his Balrog, so we'll just use camera for now so we can observe better. Menji has been defeated. And that leaves the bottom team to one person. So it is only a matter of time before he falls here. He does have himself a Shelob though. As well as a level 8 Goblin King. If Goblin King would have got to level 10, that might have been a whole different game. Gorkil's level 10 ability is very strong. Summoning, was it 2 or 3 Fire Drakes? Summons 3 Fire Drakes, yeah. It's very strong. Each one coming out with the Inferno ability. Just like this. Inferno can decimate an entire army, as you'll probably see here. Unless Random gets out of the way. It looks like he manages to get out of the way, though, before it casts. Evil Eye does almost nothing to the Fire Drake, it seems. The Mercurials are bursting it down, and they will pick it off, no doubt. Even a few of them is still very dangerous to a Fire Drake. He's going to have to use Balrog here, I think. Underneath all these Haradrim archers, maybe. That'll probably be the best bet he has. Even if he summons it in the base of one of his enemies, he won't be able to kill them with it. It just won't be able to take down a fortress and a whole base. You can pretty much do one or the other. And I'm not even sure he can take down a fortress by himself. Fortunately, though, he doesn't have to worry too much about these Haradrim archers, as they can't really do any damage. He has summoned a Balrog. Where, though, I wonder? There it is. He's opted to summon it in Gordon, but Mr. QQQQ. I don't know if that was the best of ideas. But I guess at this point, he probably realized it. I would have used it in one Valiant defense, personally. Because even if he does take out a Dwarven player, he still has to take on two teams. So either way, he's kind of screwed. Unless he's just really good. But all the players seem pretty decent, so I don't think that he'll have much chance in that respect. As you see, Balrog can take down a fort, but it'll take a while. And if dwarves have rebuilt, which they very well might, he does indeed, then Balrog will get nowhere near. Yeah, there you go. It will despawn far before he ever gets any damage done to the fortress. And that's why I always think it's never a good idea to use a Balrog on a fortress. Especially on a team that has rebuilt. And you can destroy everything except for the fortress of the Balrog. You might as well just do that. And then you could use your army to actually finish off the fortress itself. It just makes more tactical sense that way. Balrog using his fire breath on his own army. Very nice. And meanwhile, they burst down the fortress of Radagast here. Balrog and the rest of them leading the charge here. And soon Radagast will be out of the game, and the northern team will be the victors here. There we go. Radagast has been defeated. The northern team. Mr. QQ, QQ, Do Random, and Memory, the victors. So yeah, pretty cool 3v3. I always like to see a 3v3, especially on 1.08, since I don't see too many of those. But yeah, good game. Hope you guys enjoy that, and I will see you guys in the next cast of 1.08. So I'll see you guys next time.